Hey, what's going on YouTube? We're back here with another video in the Outer Worlds. We have just finished both DLCs, so we've got Peril on Gorgon completed, the first one, and then Murder on Eridanos. So we're gonna go and pick up the main storyline. I don't believe we have many other quests left besides the main storyline. We might have been able to actually complete everything else. So we're just gonna pick up. We're supposed to go to the Hope, I believe. So we will see how that leads us. Hold on, I think it's still loading in. Hold on, I hear some noise. One second. Oh, this might be a monitor issue. 2 seconds then. Hello, anybody hear me? There we go. Hold on. Oh, one more fix and we'll be good to go, guys. There we are. Let's do it now. Perfect. Sorry. That's something in my throat too. Okay, so we do need to go to the Hope docking bay. I want to go check out what I have real quickly. So I do need to go up here. Actually, I'll just check inventory. So I have stuff I need to sell too. So before we go to the Hope, God, I don't want to. Hold on, I'm gonna make a new save. I don't want to lose her as a companion, but I feel like if we go to the Groundbreaker, we're gonna lose her. So I do kind of see what happens if we go to the Groundbreaker because she's been, sort of kidnapped by us this whole time. So we will see what happens. Let's keep that in mind.
The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain.
It has
Your fleet
approved our
has arrived.
request. Yay. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do I have anything else I need to sell, though? I actually should get my. I'll get you food. I'll be back next one. Gonna end up selling a lot of stuff, but we'll see. We have 629 to drain the time, which I don't think are like particularly good. Yeah, we should get sell the spectrum too. We don't need those. We don't need those. Boys are back in town. All right, let's do it. You know what? I kind of want to take Eureka with me. I'm gonna take these. I wanna take Nova Burst, I feel like we've gotta have Nova Burst. Onslaught, Captain Robin Spine. Okay, so it's not as high as I thought it was. It also just does ballistic damage, right? Or like regular melee damage, which is kinda weird, but to be honest, I don't really need all this stuff, but 569. Doctor's orders. We had another in-ray one. I want to check those out together. Did want to check that one out as well. Primary launcher. Nature. Maybe I was just looking at. Hold on. All in does a lot. Oh yes, snipers. Um, 569 might be the most damage for a sniper that I have. Yeah, 525, and I got rid of the other one, I believe. So we're gonna take Agony with us as well. Aw, she's gone. I wonder if we can find her in the medical bay. We should try to go look for her real quickly. Since we're here. Will do. Oh, I hit E. Just gonna grab the Reverend. Isn't what he called? Max. Let's see. Oh, we're getting a little faster this time. And you've heard it once, you've heard it 1,000 times. Still my favorite place to jump around. I just like jumping feels completely different here, you know? Oh, the game kind of stuck there for a second.
Looking for some, don't take, have a look.
Have a look, see. Yeah, let's come close. Okay, so it is just money to have them repair here. Sweet. Time to sell some stuff. Oh, that's a. Oh no, this is the gun. You know what? They don't actually. Yeah, we don't need any of these. Just want to find the difference between these two. Just enter and guards. Not want to keep those. This is the best light ammo armor I have. Let's get rid of all the Rizzos. Plus one. What is this for? Hold on. What is the shampoo bottle for? Because I don't remember. I don't even remember where I got it from, to be fair. I'm honestly just looking this up real quickly. It's barely mentioned anywhere. No, oh, it might be Provardi's from the date. I wonder if that's what it is. It could be. I was going to the medical wing, which is right here. I want to see if she's here. You can let me through. Honestly, I honestly thought I was supposed to talk to her for a second. I got concerned. Oh, our friend left. It's okay, we're good. Well, I sold that stuff. What did he say? Might as well just use this one real quickly. Actually, I want to shoot in the cabin. Yes. Okay, nobody gets mad at that, which is interesting, but also just do this in the ship. I don't shoot anyone. I'm gonna take some guns out quickly, and then after I take them out, we're gonna go to the Hope. I think there's like, I want to say there's three or four more quests left, but there might be like two or three left. What do I know? I'm just the guy that plays the game. Okay, so hold on. Oh, I also realized discrepancy amplifier. I can get rid of that whenever I want. So we're gonna go put that up. So I don't need to. What is it? Well, hold on, actually, now I kind of. What the hell was that? Was he putting out a fire back here? Is that? How he gets so proud? I'm so glad I got to see that in firsthand. He just jetpacks around the jets. That's great. Okay, it's a weapon of science. All right. The true question. The idea that I could make this stronger. Wish I could just show mine sometimes, you know? Okay, so doctor's orders is as strong as it's at. So handgun 45-18 stagger, 56-18 stagger, and right type it away minus 50 damage. So doctor's orders does seem better. I'm gonna sort of spend so much into that. That's sort of a fundamental level. Okay, and then we got this one. Okay, so it's kind of strong. Kind of strong. Not gonna lie. So let me see. It's like a difference between the two. So Eureka, Doctor's Orders is the stronger one. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna get rid of Eureka. I'm trying to make sure I also have a good like basis of damage too for what I do. Where'd Eureka go? I'll go ahead and put this one away for right now. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what this one does. Okay, so it is like a heal one, which is kind of, oh, that's gonna be good to have around actually. So I'll just keep doctor's orders or employee benefits, but and doctor's orders, I like the medical thing we're going for. Okay, so these are the other two I wanted to see real quickly. This one generally seems better. So the okay, to 284. Yes, this one does more damage, it looks like, than the Plasma Carbine Ultra. 45, 40 energy. Stagger, and this does burn. Huh. Okay. So to upgrade some stuff real quickly. I think he's the chunkier boy, to be honest. Okay, yeah. I'll just put shock on this dude, you know? Interesting to see how this dude performs with shock. Actually, might keep him and try that out. Oh, I did not get an overburst. So we're gonna reorganize some stuff here. We got swords, those pistols. All right, I think I'm gonna go deposit something, and we'll try this arsenal out. What did I want to deposit though? That right there. Wait, what? You can lose it and get another one. Okay. Unfortunately, most of my weapons are special, apparently, so I just need to put them up here. I can't apparently put a whole lot of mods on them. I've already made up selling most of these, aren't I? Sell that stuff. Okay. You know what? I just want to see how well this does. My bet is we're gonna fight humans, not machines or animals on the Groundbreaker, so if we end up fighting anybody at all. So we'll save. Only if I could like it, mod these, you know?
We have arrived at the Hope. I need you to reroute power from our ship to the Hope's auxiliary generator. You'll have to connect me to the Hope's comm system so I can convince her central computer to enable the skip drive. If your calculations are even slightly off, or the sun. The Hope is the Groundbreaker's prettier, sleeker sister. She wandered off and got lost for 70 years, but just recently was found. Also, there are hundreds of thousands of frozen organic life forms hibernating in her hold.
All right, let's sneak around the Hope, where it all began. Yeah, it looks a lot like the Groundbreaker. I expected it to. Is that a ship right there? They're probably just ships with the Hope, right? Because they're meant to obviously wake up, and they didn't.
About Edgewater. I'm glad to know we still have supporters in the colony.
Who is that? Oh, hello. As long as I have been consumption, I'd be the port, it'd be a job a hell of a lot easier. Interesting. Oh, it's that dude.
You know, when they posted us here, I told them there wasn't any point. Nobody would be so stupid as to fly to the ass end of the colony for this derelict. Shows how much I know. You've got about 5 seconds to tell me what you're doing here before I make you take a walk outside.
Time to switch the old gear around. So engineering was 60 for sure. Oh wait, but I needed to lie as well. My lie's up as well. Hold on, what's going on?
Get out of here on your own accord, or we'll dump your body out the airlock. Get out of here.
Okay, hold on. We need to reload. Because I for sure met those requirements. Okay, let's do the quick save. And we'll just have to go back to that room in a second, but I for sure had those requirements. Save right here. Hold on. Let me double check. Oh no, it wasn't. That's why. Okay. both of these are over. Okay.
You know, when they posted us here, shows how much I know. You've got about 5 seconds to tell me what you're doing here before I make you take a walk outside. Explode? All right. You'll want a uniform so my staff doesn't shoot you on sight. They're a dangerous mix. We've got a few extra in the old
I'm gonna dip back out real quickly so I can get a fresh scan. Alright, let's read through these real quickly.
Stolen error. Hope crew data not found error. Paradox protection protocols.
It's okay if they don't like me. Oh, well, this is a nice little hidey hole. Oh, look, I got a key card. Where this door goes. Ooh, secret. Interesting. Oh, I wonder if I could have just gone this way. I'm loco. Of course I could have. Oh, that's Pavarotti.
Should we assign Sam for a cleanup?
Oh, gosh. Something
we said. So I guess mega sprats come from Earth. So have they been cutting up or eating people? I'm gonna go that way in a second, but I'm gonna go over here first. So just shy of 10,000 people here.
Wants to scratch my name on one of those pods? Yeah, I figured.
Quickly, we do these.
Can you hear me, Captain? I have successfully integrated myself into the Hope's comm systems, and am attempting to establish contact with the Hope's more primitive processor now. Would you like me to play a mood suitable music selection while you travel to the bridge? Oh, sorry. File not found.
Aw. See it. There's another skeleton, that's funny. Interstellar crew. Oh, they killed the Hope's crew people? That's dark, dude.
These were the private quarters of the Hope's former crew. Shall we hold a moment of silence for the dearly departed? No. That's odd, because my programming would indicate that when forced to confront the idea of self-death, organics prefer... Oh, I see. Yes, never mind.
I feel like coming home for you, boss.
Yeah, something like that.
Keep him quiet, Cap.
Oh, I thought it was gonna be like some cool named gun. It wasn't. Disappointment. Let's see.
Hold it right there! I don't recognize you. Are you new here? I'm just trying to make sure you belong here. I guess you got a point. I don't have time for this. Move along.
Oh, I thought that was like a little door or something. There's gotta be something cool hidden in one of these rooms, right? The court isn't well on that here. That's my choice.
That's the Hope's computer up ahead. I'll admit,
huh.
I'm curious to wake him.
Hey, if this all goes wrong and we end up flying into the sun, I just want you all to know it was a real pleasure.
This stuff goes wrong and we end up flying into the sun. Oh yeah, I guess it would kill everyone else too, huh? What is this? Okay, well that's something to check out in a second. Huh. I'm gonna save real quickly. And we'll respond to the computer.
Greetings, Captain. I am speaking to you through the Hope's computer system. It's a rather cramped feeling, but it'll do. Are you sure? That is extremely dangerous. Skipping the Hope will void the warranty on the skip drive. And also potentially kill an entire planet. How is my humor now, Captain? Improved? Jump-starting the skip drive. Destination set to the rings of Terra 2.
Worst ways to go out, I suppose. Nice knowing you, boss.
Doing it. I mean, affirmative. Skipping the Hope in 3, 2, 1.
ADA, does your captain seriously intend to do a micro jump in system with engines that haven't been powered in 70 years on a derelict ship?
That is what my captain intends, yes.
But that is a gross misuse of the skip drive. The Zero Point Drives Corp and I will not be held responsible for any damage incurred during transport, and this will cause extreme damage.
Yes, I am aware of that.
You should not be doing this. The humans will die.
Thank you, Hope. It looks like all systems are a go. Captain, I would advise you to hold on to something, now. Oh, good. We are still alive and have successfully skipped into Terra 2's orbit. I reported as much to Phineas Wells, but he has not responded. Perhaps you should check in on him.
Hey, we made it. Let's do it again.
I wonder if any of those guys know I'm not board certified now. That's it. Lame.
What was that? You ought to see. I don't recognize you. I'm just trying to. I don't want any trouble out of you.
Soldier. Soldier! Lame, I thought I made it. I thought I had it. I'm gonna have to take that little hide place so I can recharge. Unless he does just attack me. Like he's supposed to or something. I'm not gonna bother with that loot down there this time. We'll have to go this way to see if I can avoid a conversation.
Project error. Hope crew data error.
They want to see what's in that middle floor we can't get to real quickly. We get to see it again. What is that? I'm gonna have to go up here and refresh it right here. What reputation decrease? What are they talking about? Oh. Poor Quincy. Oh. This gun is like super powerful. Alright, let's dip. Let's get out of here. Go, go, go. Get back to the ship. I'll cover us. Ah! Just extended the line as you wait for your whole crew to get through, and you're just like, ah. I just love how nobody else is hearing this right now. Good, good.
Captain, I am receiving a Captain, I shall now play the transmission I received from Dr. Wells.
The board is here. They've found me somehow. They're about to blast my door open. I can't stop them from getting me, and there isn't enough time to explain everything. But there's something very important you'll need to remember. The board, all their lackeys, they're all a bunch of swine. Do you hear me? They're fucking corporate swine. You fucking pigs! I'll take you all out with me! I'll never...
Jesus, Phidias.
The recording captured some rather dire events. I presume you'll want to dock at the orbital lab to... How can I be of assistance? Goodbye.
Let's dock at the orbital lab.
Now arriving at Phidias' top secret orbital lab.
Alright, let's go in. So Team Phineas, let's do it. I need that heavy firepower, right? Alright, Sam, you're up. Maximum cleaning mode activated. That does say negotiate for sprouts for territory, right? That's what I'm reading correctly there. Just want to make sure. I want to make sure everybody read that with me. Did forget that I was not wearing armor. That would add up. That would add up. Let's continue. And then we'll go from there.
useless. Good news, customer. All germs and contaminants have been neutralized.
So they're doing that in-ray damage. That's what was so hurtful. Okay, Bubbles made it. We're good. Thank God Bubbles lived. I was super worried about that boy. You know how reckless he can get sometimes. I'm not to blow it or anything, but we annihilated those guys. Venus's terminal passcode. And a hoof. I mean, that's one spot to put it. I did just hack through it, though, so. We'll see. An arrest receipt, that's interesting. Check out that gun real quickly. Ooh, a new shiny toy. Oh, we're about to go mod the heck out of this one too. Oh, gotta go this way. We're gonna mod the heck out of this one too. And our tinker, I should say. And then go fight to free Phineas.
Captain, as it appears we may soon be embarking for a maximum security prison planet, I believe the crew would like to speak with you to, as you humans put it, air some concerns.
Let's talk to him.
Those Borg goons kidnapped Mr. Phineas and hauled him away to Tartarus. How are we going to get him out?
I'm not one for pointless heroism, but the Borg's going to be after us next. We going to finish what we started?
To extract the scientist, you will need to infiltrate the labyrinth. But that course of action is likely to be quite dangerous, Captain.
Unit was unable to complete scheduled sanitization service due to the following reason. Locked door.
But since no one ever makes it out, this is all just speculation.
The armed surveillance protocols on a maximum security prison planet are highly sophisticated. As such, escapes are historically quite impossible and deadly. I am programmed to warn you whenever you exhibit inclinations toward risky behavior. Breaking into Tartarus will not be easy.
Getting in is the simple part. It's getting out again that's the trouble. Trust me, I know.
Let's just do it. Kick down some doors, grab Doc Wells, and cut a path out. We don't need a plan. We got guns.
If you really mean to do this, you should see to your final affairs and close out any unfinished business. Once you sneak into Tartarus, you may be there a while. Or permanently.
It's the craziest plan I've ever heard. And I mean that as a compliment.
You didn't hire me to think. And I ain't about to start now. You're my boss. And I'll walk into fire with you.
I think it's insane. But maybe the colony needs a healthy dose of insanity right about now.
I know it's dangerous. And I won't lie and say I'm not scared out of my wits. But I couldn't live with myself if we didn't do something.
You're asking for more than bravery from us, Captain. But there are worse ways to go than dying for a good cause. I'm in.
Let Sam get the grime out. It's what our units do best.
The entire plan is a terrible idea, but I admire your bravado, Captain, which leads me to illogically believe, against the odds, that you will be successful.
If we don't make it, at least it'll be a great story.
Got my trusty tossball stick, got my ass-kicking boots. I'm ready, boss.
Outstanding.
You can count on us, Captain. We're crew. For real crew. That means we got each other's backs. Right?
Never thought I'd volunteer to break into a prison. Seems like your tendency towards risky behavior is rubbing off on me, Captain.
Command not recognized.
Waiting on your command, Captain.
Alright, let's go give the command to get ready. Look at all of my guys. My hungry guys. That SNL skit was great. Anyways, yeah, let's go do it. Let's go save Phineas, guys. I'm actually going to make a final manual save right here. Because I know we have one like right on the Hope as well, in theory, in case we ever had to turn around or something. I don't believe they're going to give any other DLCs or like big content updates or anything, but just in case. Oh, cool. Thanks. We do have, so do we even have a bathroom? But we do have a bathroom in here. Let's go to Tartarus. You are about to assault the labyrinth on Tartarus and determine the fate of Halcyon Colony. Saves made after this point can only finish the main story on Tartarus. Side quests and downloaded content, such as Peril and Gorgon or Murder on O'Donnell's, will be unplayable for any saves made beyond this point. If there's nothing you want to do before you enter the prison, do it now. Anything. Before you cross the point of no return, would you like to continue? We have made that final save. We are good to go.
I am pleased to inform you that we have arrived at the labyrinth. Please be advised that the punishment for trespassing is execution. Please be advised that electrical storms on the surface of Tartarus make departure impossible at this time. Resident count is as follows: 3,071. Resident deaths, including but not limited to executions, are as follows: 1,684. Resident escapes are as follows: 0. The interior can be chilly. Take a scarf with you, Captain. I would also ask that you leave your captain's ID with me, in the event that you do not return. I can make the assurance that I will not leave with another captain unless you do not return within 876,541,652 hours. Oh, speak of the devil. Captain, I am receiving a transmission from the prison's docking authority now.
Attention, unauthorized spacecraft. This is a maximum security installation. Your presence here is an explicit violation of UDL corporate policy. You are hereby confined to your docking platform until a ticket detailing your crimes has been filed and notarized, at which point your vessel will be seized and you will be executed. Your ship is not permitted to leave until you remit payment for your fines and submit yourself to execution. Only after your smoking corpse is thrown from an airlock will we lift the lockdown on your spacecraft.
Captain, I would not recommend this course of action.
All right. I'm feeling generous. I'm transmitting the idea of a productive, law-abiding employee so you can see what one looks like before you die. Anyway, Tartarus Docking Authority signing up. Hang on. Another ship just pulled into your dock. Wait, is that from the Groundbreaker? What the? Pay no mind to that. Just have a pleasant day.
Transmission to the Groundbreaker has come for us. The heroes have united.
How can I be of assistance? I'll be...
It'll be okay, Anubis. Just gotta grab. I'm gonna grab some gear, in case I need to do any like heavy, like engineering or anything big.
Please avoid damaging yourself or others while you are out.
I will do my best. Who do I want to go with me? Let's do it. Oh, it's Jun Lee from, the Groundbreaker. That's dope. I Interesting. Oh, no. I might be silent through most of this since this is like a pretty important. I think this is probably going to be a like a run and gun situation. So I'm probably going to be quiet through most of this so we don't miss any important dialogue, but it's cool to see that people are coming to sort of aid us like that.
Thank you.
for bars when it's got a storm like that guarding the gates.
They say nobody's ever broken out of the labyrinth. Didn't say nothing about breaking in, though.
I like the attitude, Felix. I'm liking the attitude. This is cool. If I'm going to get, like, people for my adventures and stuff to come help us out, this actually might turn out to be pretty slick.
Let's look around. There's got to be a few ways through here.
Oh, I could imagine. Pit access. Okay. I'm going to try this way. You know what, actually, I think I'm just gonna go talk to him. Or I can sneak right by him like that. That'll work. Hold on. Don't wanna go too fast now. There we go. I think we've got it. No way out. Shit. I'll have to wait for him to move. Just waiting for one of these places to have Like, I was waiting for one of those rooms to have, like, somebody just waiting in it, like, on a bathroom or something. I guess I could have gone that way too, but oh well. Oh, here we go. Need to repair everything. Okay, so this is where we can break stuff down. Okay. Where did I get that? Interesting. Right. All right, we should be good to go.
I'm working as fast as I can, all right? If y'all would quit bothering me, I'd fix in the FPS system. FPS system. Forced pacification system. If the prisoners riot, we gas them. Anyway, I need to finish.
Of course. Why? Oh, for law's sake. Fine. Just don't go shooting up the place with gas, all right?
No way, I just get this from this.
Word is tartar sauce. One word. All lowercase.
Whoops, sorry, Melody. Weird that gas also worked on the robot, but won't question it. Gotta go somewhere.
What was that? Let's go, troops. Stellar base counting on us.
Oh, okay. Let's do it. Ooh, August Vinoy. The lone captain. Yeah. Get him. I kind of don't want to know what's up there real quickly. Welcome to Earth. Let me see. I wonder if there's any goodies up here. I don't think I've ever checked up here before. Because, like, you can put a shimmy up these sometimes, it looks like. Interesting. So I guess this would have just been like a sneaky route if my disguise hadn't failed and they triggered. So I wonder, like, if I would have fought with anyone that last area, I should just sort of try to engage in combat wherever I can. Does this go anywhere? Oh, it does. It's just unfinished. Okay. And then, well, it's in a prisoner cell with some whiskey. That makes sense. It's tracking. And then, is there anything good up here, though, is the question. Let's see. No. Okay, so now we've just gone this way. Another flamethrower, yet again, very good to have in a prisoner cell. Okay, and then we would go down. Got you. Alright, so the Arcana class will hold this for me.
Let's do this.
Alright. Let's get some action going.
Welcome to the Icona class, asshole.
Hey there, how's it going?
All right, here we go.
Well, that's just rude.
Who it is. I'll be damned. I was prepping the studio for our announcement, and here you are as a bonus. And I see you've brought the kid along. Babysitters may be expensive, but they're worth it, you know.
Yeah, keep talking, pal. I'll just keep thinking of a place to bury your body.
I had heard you'd taken a mechanic under your wing. What's the matter, girl? Couldn't find actual employment?
The captain's treated me right. Better than any of you bored folk ever have. I'm exactly where I want to be.
When you go off and get yourself shot, try to avoid taking one to the face. I'll want it recognizable to show to my citizens. Haven't you heard? Phineas is working for us now. It took some doing, but employing an efficient management strategy of putting our guns to his head seems to have done the trick. Yes, he is an extraordinarily obstinate fellow, isn't he? Fine, he isn't working for us per se. Semantics, he'll come around. But that's between us. As far as my adoring citizens will know, we've turned a dangerous crackpot into a working-class man. It's a miracle. Oh yes, go on, wake them up, add more mouths to feed. That'll solve our starvation problems. I don't know what half-baked plans that simpleton in a lab coat has been leading you through, but it's done. It's over. Let me ask you something, Captain. Have you at any point thought about not fucking up our entire society?
Are you kidding me? We're out here trying to clean up your mess.
I'm making actual progress towards stabilization and recovery. You're just getting in the way. Oh, right. This coming from the psychopathic outlaw. Yes, I'll try to be more open-minded about your path of wanton dissent. We don't need your help. I'll admit, there's no shortage of talent in the scientists and engineers there. Look, I'm not an unreasonable man. If you manage to storm the castle, as it were, and make it out of here with Phineas alive... I can't exactly afford more havoc than you've already caused. Fine. If you survive, you'll need someone to sell the rest of the board on your plan.
Are you out of your mind? Rockwell's the biggest monster in Halcyon. You got any idea how many lives he's destroyed? How many people he's hurt? I've had enough. You even think about cooperating with this animal? And you and I are finished.
Interesting. Interesting. What? Ooh, what to do here? Felix. Whoa. Okay. Your loyalty is worth more than Walko's subservience. This is for the good of the colony, Felix. I'm sorry. So Rockwell does have a lot of resources, but we could just take them. Well, I wonder what he would say if I said this.
Stick it where the stars don't shine. We're done.
You know, you're a stronger captain than I gave you credit for. Maybe you really can make the tough decisions.
Wow, he really left the party, dude. I want to reload then real quickly. So what happens to Rockwell if I choose Felix? Because I wanted to choose Felix. I was just curious to see if I'd get like a persuade option there at the end. So let's see real quickly. I'm gonna skip through these real quickly.
We're out
here trying to... I'm making action. I've had enough.
If you're gonna place more faith on this brat than the chairman of the fucking colony, then there's no hope for you. I've got work to do.
So what does that do then, I wonder? Well, okay, hold on. I want to look into this. And so what did that just do for us? I'm actually going to look this up. Outer Worlds. What quest is this exactly? Brave New World. Let me look that up, because I'm curious. Brave New World. If it tells us anything about that. Okay, hold on. Okay, so hold on. Okay, Unreliable Terra 2. If you help Julian the Groundbreaker, her forces will assault the facility. Immediately, you left select door. Okay, once if you help the Arcana class on Monarch, they will assist you. Left hand side will attack guards if you help them on Monarch. Let's see. Terra 2 right now, because I skipped it to Terra 2 versus Tartarus. I wonder then, what happens if I just... I'm going to try this one more time. I know there was that perk I can get real quickly. I should have enough points to remove Felix from my party. Where was it? I think it was... Was it my perks, maybe? Hold on, I'm gonna find it real quickly. This might all be cut from the video, but let's see. Persuade. Lies. Mechanicals. Sneak. No. It was one of these, I swear it was. Unreliable. My companion is sent back to the... It's this one. My companion is sent back to the Unreliable. Oh, and I don't have enough. No. What if I just send him back to the Unreliable? Where are my companions at? Oh, they're there.
Yeah, boss? Whatever you say, boss.
Okay. Felix has left the party. But I still have him on my team, though, right? Hold on, let me look at that. Worlds. World. Either. The chairman. Okay, so if he is in the party, got you. So let's do this then. I'm gonna load the game one more time. And I'm actually gonna remove him now that we know this from the party, because I want him to stay in my squad, because Felix is a good kid. And apparently, I was reading too, there's banter dialogue.
Yeah, boss.
Back to the ship.
Whatever you.
And then I just need to make sure my persuade is high enough still. Is that 153? Oh, Ferrari does give me persuade. All right, well, guess what I'm also about to do? I'm gonna remove some stuff, put some other stuff in the top hat. Sweet. Alrighty, we're our best selves now. Alrighty, so I removed Felix because apparently, because I want the chairman to work with us, but he might be his like illegitimate son. Let's see.
Who it is. I'll be damned. I was prepping the studio for our announcement, and here you are as a bonus. I had heard you'd taken a mechanic under your wing. What's the matter, girl? Couldn't find actual employment?
The captain's treated me right. Better than any of you board folk ever have. I'm exactly where I want to be.
When you go off and get yourself shot, try to avoid taking one to the face. I'll want it recognizable to show to my citizens. My word! You've correctly identified the most recognizable man in the colony. Remarkable. It's a wonder what Phineas saw in you. Then again, he's an insane person. Thankfully, he's our insane person now. A proper company man. Yes, he is an extraordinarily obstinate fellow, isn't he? Fine, he isn't working for us per se. Semantics, he'll come around. But that's between us. As far as my adoring citizens will know, we've turned a dangerous crackpot into a working class man. It's a miracle. Oh yes, go on, wake them up, add more mouths to feed. That'll solve our starvation problems. I don't know what half-baked plans that simpleton in a lab coat has been leading you through, but it's done. It's over. Let me ask you something, Captain. Have you at any point thought about not fucking up our entire society?
We're helping, which is more than you can say.
I'm making actual progress towards stabilization and recovery. You're just getting in the way. Oh, right. This coming from the psychopathic outlaw. Yes, I'll try to be more open-minded about your path of wanton dissent. We don't need your help. I'll admit, there's no shortage of talent in the scientists and engineers there. Look, I'm not an unreasonable man. If you manage to storm the castle, as it were, and make it out of here with Phineas alive, I can't exactly afford more havoc than you've already caused. Fine. If you survive,
you'll need someone to sell the rest of the board on your plan.
All right, sweet. So we're going to keep him on retainer here because I think he could still be a viable asset. You know, we just keep him caged up like he did with the ambassador to Earth. Let's see this. Messages. Cameras. I'm trying to get straight with Akane's orders. Only a few things more from my end, but I don't know what we'll do about cameras. She says security footage ain't enough. Bad engineers for cameras. Appreciate it. Sweet. Oh, there's some notes. Some bit of adhesive notes, Marco's going to get badges, done, reprint badges, change maintenance locks, order new locks. Interesting. Sweet, because I wanted to keep Felix on my squad, but I also knew that that could cause some issues if he... I didn't want him to leave, but apparently if he's in that dialogue and I want to use Chairman as a resource, willing or not, that he would not like that idea. Which makes me believe his dialogue about him possibly being an illegitimate son is possible, and also kind of cool to the story. So I think I'm going to consider it canon. Let's see what's up here. Oh, let's get ready for war. Slight issue, accidentally hit the MSI, guys. The people that'll help you are Sunjar's people, with MSI, the Iconoclasts, with that leader who I can't remember, and let's quick save right here real quickly. And then Jun Li's people from the Groundbreaker. Interesting. Ooh, look at all these pods.
Captain, you have an uncanny talent for complicating my life. You've disrupted the balance of power. You've upset the natural order of things. You've introduced uncertainty, and there is nothing I despise more than uncertainty. I'm afraid I can't do that. I'm aware of your diplomatic talents, Captain. You have a gift for manipulation, but I warn you, I'm no easy mark. For all your talents, you are the enemy of Halcyon, and therefore you are my enemy. You make a nuanced and compelling argument. Here's my rebuttal. No. Dr. Wells is being held in my custody. His cooperation will prove invaluable, even if I have to beat it out of him. All that's left to do is put down this riot, arrest you, and then get on with the bloody business of saving this colony. Fair enough. I'm giving you exactly one chance to parlay with me. Interesting that you think I'm going to die here. I believe I'm more than capable of taking you on. Fair point. I don't know how you've managed to defy the odds. By every reasonable estimate, you should be dead. Yet here you stand. I've devoted my entire life to protecting Halcyon. I'm not afraid to die in the line of duty. There isn't much of a board left, thanks to you. You've thrown this system into disarray. Cleaning up your mess will be the work of a lifetime. You were always an unknown variable. I tried to recruit you, but you threw your lot in with that madman, Phineas Wells. Yes, I'm quite aware of your brazen act of corporate vandalism. By the way, those test subjects you killed, they died in agony. My scientists assure me they can recover the data you've destroyed. You've succeeded in temporarily delaying our research. Nothing. That isn't true. It can't be. You're trying to manipulate me. That experiment was absolutely essential to the program. Damn you. You are telling the truth. My scientists have been lying to me, and I was stupid enough to trust them at their word. We're going to have to start all over again. All that research, all those experiments, you've set us back decades. I haven't given up on the program yet. You've caused some complications, but I can improvise. I can fix this. I haven't lost control of the labyrinth yet. Our security system is still operational. I can still put a stop to you.
Damn, I need everything else higher, don't I? Here, we're gonna reload real quickly and see if I can get all this shit to 90 real quickly.
Captain, you've disrupted the balance of power. You've upset the natural order of things. You've introduced uncertainty, and there is... I'm afraid I can't do that. You have a flair for subtlety. If you'd worked for me, you would have been the greatest fixer Halcyon has ever seen. For all your talents, you are the enemy of Halcyon, and therefore you are my enemy. You make a nuanced and compelling argument. Here's my rebuttal. No. Dr. Wells is being held in my custody. His cooperation will prove invaluable, even if I have to beat it out of him. All that's left to do is put down this riot, arrest you, and then get on with the bloody business of saving this colony. Fair enough. I'm giving you exactly one chance to parlay with me. Interesting that you think I'm going to die here. I believe I'm more than capable of taking you. Fair point. I don't know how you've managed to defy the odds. By every reasonable estimate, you should be dead. Yet here you stand. I've devoted my entire life to protecting Halcyon. I'm not... There isn't much of a board left, thanks to you. You've thrown this system into disarray. Cleaning up your mess will be the work of a lifetime. You were always an unknown variable. I tried to recruit you, but you threw your lot in with that madman, Phineas Wells. Yes, I'm quite aware of your brazen act of corporate vandalism. By the way, those test subjects you killed, they died in agony. My scientists assure me they can recover the data you've destroyed. That isn't true. It can't be. You're trying to manipulate me. That experiment was absolutely a... Damn you. You are telling the truth. My scientists have been lying to me, and I was stupid enough to trust them at their word. We're going to have to start all over again. All that research, all those experiments, you've set us back decades. I haven't given up on the program yet. You've caused some complications, but I can improvise. I can fix this. I haven't lost control of the labyrinth yet. Our security system is still operational. What? You can't be serious. Oh, for the love of the law. All right. Fine. I can see when I've been beaten. Congratulations, Captain. You've outplayed me. I accept your terms and will return Dr. Wells to your care. I just hope you've made the right decision. The fate of the colony is in your hands now. I bid you farewell, Captain.
Sweet, we were able to get that resolved. I was worried I wouldn't be able to actually talk her down. Oh, this is interesting. I wonder if I would have to... Probably would have had to have fought in that giant robot, it looks like. Which I actually might go back and do, because I have that quick save I'm going to keep. So I might make a permanent save right there after I get him out, just to kind of see what that fight would have been like. I don't think I've ever fought in her before, because when I first played, I also was able to talk her down. I'm curious what that fight would look like, because it looks like that's going to lead me right up if I have to fight her. And I know she was in the room up here, so interesting that he's just kind of waiting there. Let's see.
You don't know how glad I am to see you. You must have said something to get under Akande's skin. She's gone, and I don't think she's coming back. And you... You lunatic! You broke into the board's own fortress just to rescue one doddering old man! You are absolutely out of your mind, and I can't begin to thank you enough. I know, my friend, I know. And now it's finally over. The board's finished. It's only a matter of time before the entire system slips from their grasp. You've broken the board's stranglehold on this colony, and you saved my life. But there's still so much we have yet to accomplish. You and I are going to have to work harder than ever to save Halcyon. I'm afraid the situation is far worse than any of us ever anticipated. Earth has gone dark. We haven't received a single message in 3 years. There's been no communication, no signals, nothing. 2 years ago, the Earth's Directorate's frigate disappeared on their way back to Earth. We don't know what they discovered when they arrived, or if they arrived at all.
You mean we're all alone out here? Really alone?
I'm afraid so, Miss Holcomb. Halcyon is the only home we have left. Returning to Earth is no longer an option. We're in serious trouble, my friend. Do you know what this means for Halcyon? We can't rely on Earth for support anymore. We've been cut loose. We're entirely on our own. Yes, we do. You've done a marvelous thing. You've succeeded where anyone else would have failed, including me. We must begin the revival process immediately, starting with the Hope's brightest minds, and then we're going to fix this damn colony, one problem at a time. We're going to need a leader, and I can't imagine a better person for the job than you. What do you say, old friend? Will you help us? When I revived you, I thought you were going to help me save this colony. I was wrong. I had our roles reversed, you see. You're the one who's going to save us all. I'm just the one who set you on your path. You're the best thing to ever happen to Halcyon. If you want to take it upon yourself to lead this colony, you have my support. We're not a colony any longer, are we? Our last connection to Earth has been severed, and so we have been set free. Our future is uncertain, and no one knows what tomorrow holds. Exciting, isn't it?
The OSI teaches that everything in the universe happens according to the grand plan. But the stranger that arrived in Halcyon was an unplanned variable. From the moment he landed in Emerald Vale, his actions altered the course of history. The events on Tartarus brought about the end of the Board's authority. But the Board's mistakes would haunt the colony for decades to come. The damage they left behind would require the work of a generation to repair. Dr. Phineas Wells began reviving a handful of the Hope's colonists. Engineers, scientists, technicians, and intellectuals. They were among the brightest minds the Earth had ever sent out into the stars. The Hope scientists and engineers woke up in a colony descending headlong into total collapse. With no way to return to Earth, they had no choice but to band together and devote themselves to the cause of saving Halcyon. The people of Halcyon were nothing if not hardy. In the absence of the Board's authority, many of the colony's settlements banded together with a single purpose in mind, survival. Life was especially hard in the years to come. Some towns dissolved by attrition and starvation, but most of them found a way to carry on. In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. The Board was gone, and for better or worse, the colony was responsible for its own destiny. Between MSI's worker-centric policies and the Iconoclast's manpower, Sanjar and Zora were able to rally many of the Terra II townships to their cause. MSI's workforce swelled, and the Iconoclast enjoyed a significant surge in their ranks. The Board was too distracted by infighting and internal politics to stop MSI from becoming a powerful corporation and a refuge for townships that might have fallen through the cracks. Consumed by paranoia, Lilia Hagen took sublight salvage in a controversial direction, openly accusing Board officials of an extraterrestrial conspiracy. One day, an accident at the Groundbreaker's docking bay silenced her forever. Time would tell if her replacement could keep the Sublight family together. Adelaide McDevitt replaced Reed Thompson as the leader of Edgewater. She and her followers transformed Edgewater in their image. Anyone loyal to Reed was pressured into leaving town, and those who stayed behind adapted to her way of life. Adelaide transformed the old cannery into a new garden. The nearby Edgewater Cemetery provided a convenient source of fertilizer. Under the leadership of Junlei Tennyson, the Groundbreaker held firm against corporate influence. The ship's mechanical stability gave Junlei the time to educate a promising generation of engineers schooled in her family's traditions. The future of the Groundbreaker looks promising. The rediscovery of the Hope and the abandonment of the Lifetime Employment Program forced Byzantium to come to terms with some uncomfortable realities about the state of Halcyon. While Byzantines were reluctant to surrender the luxuries they'd grown accustomed to, the board's diminished authority gave them little choice in the matter. Nearly everyone had to learn to make do with less. Some even had to get jobs. It was a dark time indeed. Even the Gorgon asteroid, though a distant enigma to most of Halcyon, felt the aftershocks of your actions. Olivia and Minnie Ambrose worked together to cure the marauders Adrena Time had created. Through their partnership as scientist and administrator, they discovered the harmony that had eluded them as mother and daughter. And through years of patience and effort, they discovered a means to wean Halcyon from the scourge of Adrena Time. Their work eventually allowed Wells and his scientists to treat many of Halcyon's marauders. As their addiction waned, the colonists who had lived for so long under the thrall of Adrena Time returned to their communities and loved ones and joined in the effort to save Halcyon. In spite of everything, the Gorgon asteroid remained a sobering reminder of the potential for progress and disaster in humanity's most ambitious efforts. The Rizzo's company in Halcyon dissolved after the collapse of the board. Needless to say, the launch of Spectrum Brown was indefinitely delayed. A stockpile of Spectrum Brown remains buried deep beneath the ruins of the old distillery, abandoned to time and attrition. With the dissolution of the board, Ruth Bellamy found herself without the two constants in her life, Byzantine culture and her sister Belinda. In the face of this new reality, she struggled to find a direction for her life. The colony had moved on from Halcyon Helen and would require new heroes in the years to come. And so Ruth Bellamy decided it was time to exit stage left. She quietly disappeared from public view. The dissolution of the board did not mean the dissolution of the ambitions of Cedric Kincannon, the charismatic leader of Sublight Underground. Cedric offered Slug's transportation services to the newly thawed colonists and set to work ferrying resources and food wherever they were most needed. For better or worse, Slug headgear became fashionable in the following years. As the board began to disintegrate, Spencer Woolrich found himself at a crossroads. Cling to what little stardom remained to him, or help usher Halcyon into its new future. To the surprise of many, perhaps himself most of all, Spencer chose the latter option. Having learned a variety of different skills in the many different roles played throughout his lengthy career, Spencer founded a radio serial dedicated to staying alive despite the odds. His subjects included how to survive violent encounters with only grazing wounds, dispense pithy one-liners for tense scenarios, and, of course, how to look good doing both. After a brief attempt at dating Helen as one person rather than two, which both Bertie and Helen found too strange. Bertie struck out on his own to try his hand at raising woolly cows. Many of his former Rangers teammates soon followed, accompanied by the woolly cow the team had originally plied with alcohol. The dairy farm thrived under Bertie's leadership and care. The Dairy Rangers privately believed that the woolly cows softened Bertie's temper considerably, although the only one brave enough to say this to his face was promptly headbutted. Due to the board's dissolution, many of the Prophet's old customers no longer found quite the same value in productivity seminars that they once had. With her business drying up, the Prophet chose to take her followers down a new path. Months later, salvagers on Eridanos found clues leading them to a seemingly abandoned bunker out in the wilderness. Inside, they discovered horribly mangled corpses sacrificed to a blood-scrawled portrait of a sprat-headed deity. The Prophet was not among the bodies. Your influence shifted Ellie's perspective. She finally admitted, albeit grudgingly, that she just might need other people. Sometimes. With a steady income from the life insurance payouts, she was finally able to afford a ship of her own. She hired a small crew and flew supply missions to communities on the fringe. Some of them were even legal. Life in Halcyon was sobering for Felix Maelstone. The grand revolution he dreamed of never came. There was no great awakening for the colony, no celebrations in the streets. There was only the hard, desperate work of trying to repair a broken colony. Felix never had a head for numbers, but if there was labor to be done, he was there to help. Eventually, Felix realized that the work of a revolution was done with two hands. As much as he enjoyed his adventures aboard the Unreliable, the vicar, known as Max, eventually decided that it was time to move on, to live out the life he had sought so long to create. He knew there were many in the colony who carried burdens much worse than the ones he had struggled with, and he devoted himself to easing their suffering wherever he could. He only ever took up arms again to defend the defenseless. Unshackled from a lifetime of striving and fighting the universe and himself, Vicar Maximilian de Soto was finally at peace. Once the matter with the Hope colonists was resolved, Junlei bashfully asked Parvati if she'd like to join her permanently on the Groundbreaker, and Parvati enthusiastically, if somewhat awkwardly, agreed. The stories of her adventures spread across the colony, and Parvati soon found herself the center of attention. Having served as the engineer of a renowned spacecraft, tramp freighters and wildcat miners sought her out by name. And in no time, she was a fixture in the Groundbreaker's mechanical ecosystem. She and Junlei were never far apart. Nioka returned to Monarch to take another crack at making a permanent life for herself. She formed the Charon Group, a mercenary outfit of ragtag survivalists and wilderness experts. Anyone in need of a guide, or just looking to throw back a beer and swap stories, could find her camping on the trail, or clearing an infestation. The SAM unit that accompanied you spread awareness of the product line's superior sanitation and maintenance capabilities across what was left of the colony. This led to a boost in SAM unit sales. Did you know that SAM units are the longest-lasting, toughest-acting cleaning solution in Halcyon? Minister Clark was released from house arrest, and his contact with you gave him a sense of renewed purpose and vigor. Once it became clear that no help would be coming from Earth, he threw his considerable efforts and talents into helping Halcyon manage the crisis before it. It was widely suspected that Sophia Akande was the true power behind Chairman Rockwell. However, after the riots on Tartarus, she was never again seen in the colony. Various theories circulated as to her fate. Some believed she boarded an interstellar ship capable of journeying to a distant colony. Others believe she died trying to escape Tartarus. Some few suggest she fled to Monarch, where she continued to live among a small band of loyalists. There is another theory, which suggests that Sophia's encounter with you changed her, and she deliberately retreated from public view, but continued supporting the colony in secret. When Dr. Wells began reviving the Hope's colonists, he found himself with a sudden windfall of additional supplies and resources, courtesy of an anonymous donor. If Wells knew who his supplier was, he never told a soul. Chairman Rockwell served as the public face for the changes in Halcyon to come. Whenever you needed strings pulled or a voice to sell a policy change, Rockwell was only too happy to oblige. As for Dr. Phineas Wells, he spent his remaining years in his orbital lab. He eventually came to terms with his own past and was able to forgive the mistakes of his younger self by devoting his remaining years to serving the colony. Dr. Wells was able to revive many more scientists and engineers than he first expected, thanks to the additional batch of chemicals you stole from the Ministry. Wells never forgot about the human lives that were lost in acquiring these chemicals. In the end, Dr. Wells was able to save every scientist and engineer aboard the Hope. Over the next decade, nearly all of the Hope's remaining colonists were successfully revived. Halcyon saw a period of rapid technological and scientific advancement. Breakthroughs in dietary supplements saved the colony from starvation. Geoengineering projects and social reforms began to change the structure and character of the colony. Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the project to save the colony, but he would never live to see the fruits of his labor. He passed away a few years later. His work was carried on by the scientists and engineers he revived. Today, Halcyon has stabilized. The people of the colony work hard to adapt to their new circumstances. Nearby colonies send aid and supplies. Life will never be easy in Halcyon, but for the first time in its history, there exists a sense of real, genuine hope about the future. And what about you? The unplanned variable in the history of Halcyon. Long after Wells passed away, you carried on his work with more energy, determination, and brilliance than he could ever muster. The years that followed were hard, but Halcyon survived by the efforts of the Hope's most promising colonists, the greatest of which was you. No one knows what's happened to Earth. And no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this. The name of the Unreliable and that of its intrepid captain will remain the subject of countless stories for years to come.
All right, guys. Just want to start by saying thank you so much for any and everybody who has stuck with me through this series, through this game. Incredible game. I enjoyed it when it first came out, and getting to kind of go back and replay it and also play the DLCs for the first time were incredible. I think they added like amazing viewpoints and like amazing stories to the already wonderful game. I did absolutely enjoy this game. I loved every bit of it. I'm really interested to see if they ever do like an Outer Worlds 2 or some sort of sequel that kind of touches base on what might have happened to Earth and sort of what the colony would look like after these technical innovations. I'm interested in all of that. I know as of this recording there isn't any sort of word on a second Outer Worlds because they have, Obsidian that made this has, you know, been acquired by Microsoft, so they're working on Avowed. There's that sandbox survival game where you're tiny. I can't think of it right now. So they're working on a lot of different stuff. I'll be interested to see that. But again, this is a wonderful game. Anybody considering getting it or on the fence about it, I would definitely say do it. It's going to be a wonderful RPG to play through. But anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching this with me. And as always, I hope you guys have a good time.